Welcome back to Flat Hats at Home, bringing a little bit of Redwood National and State Parks to you and your home. This episode is sure to spark your interest. Oh, and speaking of sparks, sounds like I gotta go. Ranger Brad, it's all you.
Thanks, Ranger Allie. Hi, everybody. My name is Ranger Brad, and I am currently teleworking out of my home office. Now, today I'm going to talk to y'all about wildfire and its relationship with the Coast Redwood Forest. Now, wildfire can be a very scary topic to talk about because wildfire is a very destructive force of nature. But I found that the more we learn, the less we fear. So today we are going to learn about how fire is created in the first place, and then find out what happens when fire enters a coast redwood forest. Now, to better understand a fire, we need to learn about what is needed to create fire. It's a very simple recipe. It only requires 3 ingredients. Now, I have all my ingredients around me right now. I just need something to mix them all together. Ooh, thanks, disembodied arm. Now, the first ingredient is fuel, and fuel is anything that can burn, like this piece of wood right here. The second ingredient is all around us. Take a deep breath. That's oxygen, and oxygen supports the chemical process that creates fire. The last ingredient is heat. Now, in nature, heat only comes from 2 different sources, and that would be lightning and lava. Now, lucky for us at Redwood National and State Parks, there is no lava here, but I'm gonna add that to the mixture anyway. Take my trusty spoon, stir it up, and if I'm lucky, I added the incorrect amount of ingredients to create fire.
These 3 ingredients create the fire triangle. They react with each other in different ways, but if you take any one of them out, the fire will not burn. Amazingly, coast redwood trees have adapted to fire. Just like giant sequoias, mature coast redwood trees have a very thick bark, sometimes up to 1 foot thick. This armor protects the living part of the trunk, the cambium. The bark may burn, but not too much. This is because they only have a very small amount of a flammable substance in the bark called resin. Resins help trees cover wounds like a scab, but coast redwood trees don't need it. Coast redwoods also lose their lower branches as they grow, so even if a fire climbed up the trunk a bit, there's very little chance it would reach the branches and start the top of the tree ablaze. These trees are not fireproof, but they are very fire resistant. This means a fire could still wound a coast redwood and leave a lasting reminder of its power. If a fire was to ignite a large amount of leaf litter that is piled up on the base of a coast redwood, or if reoccurring fires come in contact with the same area of bark, that fire could burn so hot that it may bore a hole through the thick bark and leave a cavern inside the tree. They can vary widely in size. So long as the thin layer of cambium underneath the bark is not destroyed in a complete circle around the coast redwood, the tree will continue to live. But believe it when I tell you, a fire can actually be beneficial to the health of a coast redwood forest. Fire helps coast redwoods in 2 ways. First of all, it is a challenge for the small redwood seeds to find their way to the mineral soil of the forest floor. Most seeds land on ferns and other plants. Other seeds can't make it to the soil because of a layer of dead leaf litter blanketing the forest floor. We call this duff. A fire would burn these obstacles away and give those seeds a chance to find the soil. Secondly, the plants and duff on the forest floor are chock full of nutrients, such as calcium, magnesium, and potassium. If a fire was to enter the forest, the fire would burn at a low intensity. This is because of moisture that is locked inside the forest from winter rains. Instead of the nutrients being lost to the fire, they are recycled back into the soil to create a natural fertilizer that redwood seeds can feed off of. While naturally caused wildfire can be very beneficial to a redwood forest, we need to make sure that the only fires we're setting are in campfire rings like this one right here. We don't know when the next wildfire will enter the forest, but we do know that most all these redwood trees will survive, and it's going to result in new redwood trees getting their chance to grow super tall and big and healthy to impress future generations of humans. I really hope you guys learned a lot. Back to you, Ranger Allie.
Thank you so much, Ranger Brad. If you folks have any burning questions about wildfires or about fire safety, drop those in the comments below and we will be happy to answer any questions that you might have. Next week's episode is going to be truly excellent. We're going to be talking with Ranger Matt and Sam about some of our shorebirds and the amazing adaptations that their eggs have. Thank you so much for tuning into this episode of Flat Hats at Home, bringing a little bit of Redwood National and State Parks from our home to yours. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like or maybe even give us a share. Redwood National and State Parks is committed to bringing as much of our park to your home as we can during this unprecedented time. So please stay healthy and stay safe.